Joining me now, though, for his initial summation is Fox News senior judicial analyst Judge Andrew Napolitano. Judge, okay, so he deviated from what would be considered the norms with regard to procedure. He was even insubordinate, but no political bias. So my question is, so what?
My response is, so what? If this is the most damning part of the report about Jim Comey, he should go out with his wife and celebrate tonight. There is nothing new here. We already knew that he violated procedures when he himself announced she wouldn't be prosecuted. That's not a decision for the FBI.
Right.
We already knew that he violated procedures when he said we can't prove intent, so we don't think any prosecutor would take this. Espionage is not an intent crime. You only have to prove gross negligence. We already knew that he made errors of judgment when he said no prosecutor would take the case because the evidence of her guilt is overwhelming. We already knew that a foreign actor, that is an intelligence agent from a foreign country adverse to the United States, had gotten into at least one of her secret emails but had access to many of them. So none of this is new here. The Rudy Giuliani claims that Jim Comey is going to be prosecuted as a result of the report. There's nothing there. There's no criminal referral. There's no allegation of criminal behavior on his part. There are allegations of wrong judgment. We knew about that. And there are allegations that he was off on his own, making his own rules, using the FBI as he saw fit, irrespective of his bosses in the Justice Department. We already knew that.
So I would imagine that Democrats and Republicans could probably agree that Mr. Trump did the right thing by firing him.
Well, there is something in this report, and again, I haven't seen it because 500 pages that was posted as you and I were sitting here watching the end of Neil's show. There's something for everybody in this.
Right.
There's criticism of Jim Comey for announcing the reopening of the Hillary investigation 10 days before the election. Mrs. Clinton will take solace in that. She blames that single act for her defeat, whether you accept that view or not. She does make that
blame. Russians.
Right. She does make that claim, and it's now been substantiated in the report. But Republicans will say, look, he employed people in the FBI who hated Donald Trump and who sent emails and texts to each other saying we got to stop him from becoming president. Now, is that because of his personality? Is that because of his ideology? Is that because they want Hillary? We don't know. Because the bottom line is, this is a head scratcher. From the inspector general, their motivations were not political.
So what about those emails that we've pored over between Peter Strzok at the time and his girlfriend slash colleague Lisa Page? It was very clear that in the upper echelons of the FBI,
there was animus.
And like, what do we do to stop this from happening if Mr. Trump, you know, from becoming president?
I would imagine that Chris Wray, who is Jim Comey's successor as the director of the FBI, will make certain that if people have very, very strong political opinions one way or another, they get off of cases that could implicate politics.
So they should recuse themselves.
Right, go chase some terrorists or bank robbers. But if you have a strong political opinion and politicians are involved and the opinion is so strong, it's going to affect your law enforcement judgment, you shouldn't be on the
Andrew McCabe, for example, should have recused himself because of his family ties to the Democratic Party.
Let me give you the strongest argument against Jim Comey, just from the snippets of the report that Edward and the others have been giving us. He gave his people too long of a leash, knowing, or he should have known, that they had political animus in favor of Mrs. Clinton or against Donald Trump. He should have managed them better. Is that a crime? No. Is it the thing you expect of an FBI director? Of course not.
Should Hillary Clinton have been charged for her actions by using her private email server to conduct the most top-secret levels of communication as Secretary of State?
I've been arguing for 2.5 years the answer to that is yes. In fact, I've been very critical of the president and of Jeff Sessions. If the reason they fired Jim Comey is because of his exoneration of Hillary, why haven't they corrected that exoneration? They're not bound by his decision. The statute of limitations has not yet run. The evidence of her guilt is overwhelming. I could find two dozen federal prosecutors that would take that case tomorrow.
So, as you called it, a great big, or as Hillary Clinton would probably call it, a great big nothing burger? Is that where we're going with this?
It almost is that. Now, we may get more information when Mike Horowitz, the inspector general, testifies for 2 days next week.
Should be interesting.
You're also going to get, I predict this, you're going to get subpoenas from Congress looking for drafts of the report.
Oh.
Because the only thing that came out today is the final version. Did you gin something up? Did you dial something back? We're going to be going through all
that.
Did
you change it from grossly negligent to extremely careless?
There you,
those types of things.
Yes, exactly.
All right. Judge, great stuff.